laughter back at you. I have a feeling you may know what you want to do next.
I saw something with my little eye that made me excited. 1453.
Tom Waits' Story of Sisyphus.
And the crowd goes wild with recognition.
Credit where credit is due. That was a very good Tom Waits.
Thanks. I hope you don't want me to sing again.
5 points for you, Ross.
I'm going to be perfectly real with you. I didn't realize I was going to watch this much of her, but I don't know. Sally just kind of has like this soothing thing to her that I normally don't see in a lot of other vloggers. Or if anything, I imagine that she's one of the OG vloggers I used to watch back in the day. She just gives off that vibe, which is really nice. And I can tell you right now, not a lot of other YouTubers would really be the way she is. Or maybe I just haven't looked at it too much, but I remember finding her on TikTok and then shortly after that, I realized she had a YouTube channel, and I realized even after that that she's a really damn good YouTuber, and I don't really watch her TikToks all that much. I mean, I do, but I really enjoy the YouTube content more. She really knows how to flourish in a more open environment with YouTube than TikTok, and that's kind of a weird thing to say, but I feel like if you've watched YouTube since you were, like, a lot younger, like back in the late 2000s, early 2010s, you kind of get an idea of what I'm talking about. That's not meant to be taken as like as a disingenuous thing I'm saying. I legitimately think that she is so talented on YouTube that I love that she's been posting more vlogs lately. I didn't mean for this to be like a Sally Dar appreciation thing, but yet it seems like it is. So, hey Sally, if you're watching, love your stuff, very much so. And yeah, besides that, it's Thursday night, my day off again. It is currently 6:00. I am in Brand Park in Glendale, and
And, well, as you can see, there's, I guess a good amount to explore around here.
So, I'm not well. I'm not. I keep thinking that I might have some form of, I don't know, like a blood clot or blockage or something, and I've gone to the doctor so many goddamn times about this. I can't keep going back to the doctor. I just can't. I really honestly can't. I'm gonna lose my mind if I go again. And I'm really just not in a good spot right now. I really am not. I'm, if anything, just, I just hate this so much. I just hate this so much. I hate that every second of this so much. The one thing I don't like about anxiety is that it always makes you think you have something. Health anxiety is even worse because you're almost set on thinking you have it. Every little thing you feel, everything you do, it always just feels like you have something going on, and I really don't like it anymore. I really don't like it. It just feels awful. It's like this nagging thing that never goes away. You know, I really wasn't going to record this. I really wasn't. Like, I feel like almost this is too vulnerable, but it doesn't fucking matter, man. It's like my face feels hot. I felt like I can't really feel the left side of my arm or here, my leg, whatever. It's like I've felt all of these same fucking feelings again and again and again and again and again and again, and it doesn't fucking end. It's like it's almost just like the aggravation, the frustration. Like, if you can boil down what this feeling is, it's like three different feelings. The first part of it comes in, and it's almost like this sense of denial where it's like, oh, well, nah, that doesn't make sense. It can't be that. But, you know, I'm just going to keep rolling with it. then the stuff that you're feeling is more present, where it's like you start to feel more of what you're feeling in a certain area, or 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 in a certain area. And you keep focusing on it. And you end up getting to a point where you're like, oh, why hasn't this gone away? What is happening here? I don't understand it. And then the third phase of it is just fully accepting that you might have it, and you end up either going to the hospital, or you just have to ride out what you're feeling until either you die or you're fine and you move on to the next thing. For some people, they may think that I'm kind of losing my mind, or that this isn't normal, or that this is not what anxiety is like. This is what anxiety is like. It's constant like this. And no one ever seems to talk about this level of anxiety. And it's awful, you know? Like, I go to therapy. I have a therapist. I've been talking with him for like 4 weeks now. And one of the things that I've been trying to incorporate into my life is like mindfulness, you know? Like making sure that you have your mind present on other things that aren't the thing that you're freaking out about. But it's really hard when those feelings that are overtaking your head get so much worse. It's like, it's almost as if it's this overpowering thing that always succeeds and never fails. And when you're a part of it, it is just like this hell. It is so, it's almost like debilitating, where it's like you can't do anything. It's like, it's the worst feeling in the world. Like, I'm still feeling what I'm feeling. I'm still trying to not take in all the negativity of it, but it is not good, man. It feels shitty. It's the worst feeling in the world. Like, I feel it right here, these two spots. Like, in my jaw and in my eye, it just all feels like... Like, I felt it, like, from here going into my head, down into my jaw, into my eye, going all over here, and then it goes down my arm, and there's had times where I've had to clench this, and then it goes down into my leg right here. It's all only on the left side of my body. And then I thought at one point I had an issue with my appendix, and then at one point I thought I had an issue with my aorta, and then it's like it never ends. The way that I am right now, the way that I feel, the way all of this is what I have dealt with almost every day on a consistent basis. That whenever one thing ends, another thing starts. And then when that thing ends, finally the next thing starts. And then when that thing ends, the next thing starts. And it's like, open Filmic Pro. Thank you.
my goodness, my Winnipeg.
The frames are fine. What is that? But have you seen my Winnipeg? Is the guy mad?
No, I've never seen that. I wanted to see that. He shot that in black and white, I think.
Cranes are flying. Have you seen Letters Never Sent?
Of course.
That.
Yeah.
That.
Letters Never Sent.
Movie.
Well, that's a movie. No, that's a movie. Put my hand down, let your family. I know you're on my dress. You better stop a mother's better cup. It's not a woman's promise, consequences. Heel toe, heel toe. Welcome to the friggin' pain rodeo.
God, this is the best one. The best one. Tom Cardi, if you're watching, thank you.
We like eyes from across the room. Say what's up, what's up. And I say what's up, what's up. Know that it's real. I'm gonna pay you. I'm gonna come and
make another one.
But you're gonna have sex.
Better go sex.
But not just here. I'm gonna pay you.
Now I know what you want, and I'm gonna give it to you, baby.
I'm gonna pay you. I wanna have sex definitely tonight. But first, I wanna get your head right. I'm gonna pay you. If I'm starting, you know that I'm starting, because I'm better starting. Crash after me, I'll run down in the morning. I'll get back later.
Rainy blustery day. upstairs and people making their way. And I park myself in the lobby and sit in a big purple chair. And I wave at all the strangers that come into the room. And people say, who's that there? And I say, hello, lady with a bird. And hi, fellow with the ugly hat. And hey, hola to you.